Welcome to BISP. Today we will learn about a contingent consideration under financial consolidation basics. First, we quickly learn about a brief introduction about contingent consideration. A holding company or purchaser may purchase a subsidiary in following manners also, in addition to cash or a bank payment. Deferred cash consideration, contingent consideration, share for share exchange. Contingent consideration can be defined as the obligation of the purchaser, that is holding, to pay additional consideration to the subsidiary, but the consideration will be paid only when certain target or goal is achieved or conditions are fulfilled or some events may occur and similar. For example, the subsidiary company is expected to acquire a new, a very large or big order. So the holding company or the parent company may say, okay, we will pay you the additional amount, additional consideration, if you achieve that big order or acquire you that big order. So in other words, payment of consideration oblique amount is conditional, depends upon some future event. That is, if they acquire that big order, so the additional consideration will be paid to them. The amount of contingent consideration paid is recorded at its fair value in the books of acquiring entity. Provision for this amount will be made in consolidation as there is an element of uncertainty in it. So we will go towards our Excel example. The figures of a purchaser and a subsidiary is given here, and in additional information we have 70% shares were purchased by Micro Limited in Mini Limited. That is, a 100% acquisition is not there. The non-controlling interest calculation will be done here. Similarly, in addition to cash consideration, contingent consideration of 45,000 will be paid if subsidiary receive the pending big order. That is, if they receive that big order, they will be paid an additional consideration of 45,000. Similarly, the fair value of contingent consideration is also given here. That is 38,000, and 50,000 is the fair value of non-controlling interest, which is also given here. So moving towards the adding the assets and liability of both the company, simply trade receivables, cash and bank equipments. We ignore the investment made and goodwill. Working is needed, and a share capital of only purchaser will come here, and for all the three below component, working is required. And for trade payable, we will simply add the figures of purchaser and subsidiary. So first we will make the calculation of goodwill. So for arriving the goodwill calculation, we need the fair value of contingent consideration, that is the present value of contingent consideration, which is given here as 38,000 here. And the contingent consideration which is payable after 1 year or near future is 45,000. So the difference of rupees of 7,000 will be our contingent consideration, for which we will be making provision. So for goodwill, 2,50,000 is the investment amount, purchase price. 50,000 is the fair value of contingent consideration, which is given here, of non-controlling interest. Fair value is given here, 50,000. This is one. And the contingent consideration, the present value, 38,000, which is also given here. We will be adding these three figures and deducting the share capital of subsidiary. So when we do this calculation, the balance come as 1,88,000. This will be our goodwill. So we will put this figure under goodwill in asset side. And for retained earning, 1,15,000 is the retained earning of purchaser. So this figure is coming from this side. And the 70% share, since they have acquired 70% share. So the 70% share from subsidies retained earning will come to arrive at our total retained earning. So 70% of 1 lakh is 70,000. And this provision of 7,000 will be deducted from here. 1,78,000. Retained earning will be our combined retained earning will be our 1,78,000. Similarly, for non-controlling interest, as the fair value of non-controlling interest is given here, 50,000, we will be use this figure here to arrive our non-controlling interest amount. And non-controlling share of subsidiary, that is of mini limited, so the non-controlling interest is 30%. So 30% of 1 lakh is 30,000. So by adding this figure, our non-controlling interest amount is arrived, that is 80,000. We will be putting this figure under liability side in under for non-controlling interest. And liability for contingent consideration, which is given here, that is a 45,000. We will be putting this figure here to make our balance sheet balanced. So we seen our balance sheet is balanced. 8,93,000, 8,93,000. Hope you find this session useful. Thank you.